I've come to Pathelly to join my friends Louise and Mike, who are sailing around Britain. And we're going to go from here to Aberdaron today, maybe go through Bardsey Sound, just depends how things fall. And then we're hopefully going to get up to the Menai Straits and through there, which is my backyard, as it were. So we're leaving Pathelly, North Wales. They've been digging out the channel to make it wider, and this is what they've dug out.
So buoyant now. Yeah.
That's the depth, that 5.3 metres below the keel.
Whether it would work in...
I go by this guy, David Rainsbury, and his pilot. He reckons that at 5:30 we could go through Bardsey Sound.
Oh, well, let's do that then, because that gives us three hours of daylight to get round the other side.
If everybody's happy with that, it means jilling around here. Maybe we'll anchor up somewhere.
Have a bit of lunch somewhere.
See if we can find a bit of breeze just to do some sailing.
Yeah.
I'll be with any plans you make.
Good.
And it's a nice neat
ceremonial peeling of the protective strip.
Of the new
And minus is out, Mike, so that's... Oh no, plus is out. Oh, you're going to have to redo it.
We're going to have to recalibrate
you
it.
You are.
I'll just get the book. My new tiller, Steve.
I did, and it's made of ash, isn't it?
It's made of ash.
And you made it with your own fair hand.
My own fair hand. Hewn from English ash.
With a flint.
No, with an edge.
I think there was a bit of electrical help along
the
way.
There might have been a circular saw involved somewhere along
the line. Steve, you're going to be doing this all the time. You're going to be pushed overboard.
Yeah, well, at the age of 13.
Not a lot of boats out there. Here to the start of the race. Posts. Can I come past, Mike? I want to go and take a contact.
So we've just seen a dolphin. There he is, there he is.
Where?
Just off the port, Starboard Bow.
Oh, yes, I see it in the water.
Here he is.
Yes, there he is. Lovely.
Come on, give us a display. Nope. This is Hell's Mouth. Very exposed to southwesterly winds and very popular with surfers.
Something about that. I love stealing.
Yeah, so the anemometer is not spinning round.
So the apparent wind is zero, but the true wind is two. Okay?
Run that by me again.
The apparent wind is zero because the boat speed is the same as the wind speed. We're going forward at exactly the same speed as the wind is coming towards us. Therefore, it's cancelling the wind out completely. The apparent wind speed is zero. But the true wind speed is two knots.
In which direction?
That way.
It's coming from there or going to there?
It's coming from there.
And there's right. More to come. Look, you're going past those things. And look, you are going past it.
Hurtling past.
Hurtling.
Where are they?
Just a million miles away down there, actually.
So we've been past those boys three times so far. Okay, we're going to attack. All right.
I'm not like this business. I really.
There's none of this ready about Lee Ho Hoo Ha, is there?
No. There is sometimes. Mind your ankles. Well, why are you turning back down here?
I'm going to bear away.
Where's this wind coming from now? He's gone around
beating.
With us.
I'm beating.
Backwards. There are boys are over there.
It's a tide driven knock.
It's a tide driven. Let's go back again, shall we?
Ooh, I don't know.
Too much sail, Louise.
Yeah.
Well, shall I do something about it?
Shall we? Okay. You'll be not doing a reef, sir.
That is not Bardsey Island. So that is Ynys Gwilyn Fawr, meaning big, nearest us, and Ynys Gwilyn Bach, which is the farthest one, meaning small. And Ynys meaning island.
Okay, here, Mike.
And there is Aberdaron. It's just hove into view. And over there, behind Ynys Fawr, in the distance is Bardsey Island. And that is Bardsey Sound, and we'll be going through there later.
Is there any current in here? Not much. Got no speed.
Well, let it drift back a bit.
Sorry, I've got to start that again, Mike.
What?
I've got to start that again, I have no way.
Okay, keep going a little. If you need to just give it a little bit just to push it in. Okay, Louise.
What did you say?
Okay.
Could we have it again?
5:30, bang on time.
5:30, 16 knots of breeze.
What's the problem with 16 knots of breeze?
I don't like it.
You love it.
Or are you happy as you are?
Well, we'll put the jib up.
When we know how much sail we want.
Yeah.
Oh, God, I did see a buoy on it, a flag on it, on the lee.
Yep. Well, if you want to sail higher.
Yeah, I'm coming. I'm not sailing higher because I've got a.
No.
Is she fishy? Can't see any overboard.
No. With any luck, we might not.
So, Bardsey Island, Bardsey Sound, here we come.
Do you need jibing gloves?
Thank you.
Okay.
Yep.
Well done, sir.
We'll just need it like this, shall we? Thank you.
And where are we exactly, Mike?
Well, I'd say we were pretty much smack in the middle of Party Sound there, Steve.
So from this angle, Bardsey Island is a completely different shape.
Well, round is how we got, but we slowed down the back.
So what was that, those overfalls over there?
The tripods.
The tripods, yes. Don't look too threatening today. And there's the lighthouse. The last time I saw that was 30 miles away in the Irish Sea, in the dead of night.
Say again.
Just passing your shoes a bit much to put them on over thick socks.
So did you sleep well, you two?
Oh, I like a log, Steve.
Very well, thank you very much. A bit cold. But, it didn't take long to go off last night.
Rock-a-bye baby. That's Port Incline over there. It's the sun coming up. Doon Peninsula. Mike, let's get the anchor up. So we live in Port Incline. I look extremely stupid because it's been 6 degrees in the night, but I'm at least warm. And later on today, it's going to be t-shirt weather. I think maybe even no t-shirts. We're going to go through the Menai Straits, through the Swellies.
going all right. I'm going to get less of...
On this boat, we have a trusted auto helm that has been well mounted, like the last boat I was on. So last night when we were getting the sail down, there was a bit of a problem here, which Mike is going to fix. So is that again?
This is the gate. Thing, the thing that we had that went.
And I think what had happened was the rubber had become less spongy or more spongy, and it had started to sag in there. So there's quite a lot of tension on that. So actually, it's catching there. See? I think it got jammed by that. And as the sail slide came down, it jammed behind one of those forks.
Right.
And bent it.
So you're able to push it in so that you can get the carriages into the slot.
I took it out.
Actually. No, I mean now.
Yeah.
The whole idea is that you can push them into the slot, but when it comes down, they don't go in.
The whole idea is that they do this. Slide down.
Yeah, and stay on the mast rather than coming off. Yeah, got
it. How many others was that it?
Splice with my little eye.
Something that she is. Oh, okay. You wipe the bottom seat, sit on, yes.
Nothing to rock it off the hinges.
Yeah.
But if you push firmly, I think you'll find it more effective.
We're approaching the Carnarvon Bar at the moment, and we're looking for the first buoy so that we can navigate by the buoys on our way in. And it's very calm.
I spot something ahead.
Oh, and something has been spotted ahead.
I'm curious as to whether it's anything or not, I don't
So this is what we're looking for. We can see that lighthouse. And there is a buoy. That's what we're looking for. And there's another one to the right of that somewhere. So that's the port hand buoy. And that over there is the starboard hand buoy. That's what we were heading for. And now as we pass the first starboard hand buoy, we can see the next buoy beyond.
Yeah, I think so too.
So there we are, going past the first port hand buoy. Crossing the Carnarvon Bar, this is what we're worried about, is the depth. That's 3.8 metres below the keel at the moment, which is plenty, but down to 3.7. Message in a bottle.
A plastic bottle.
I'm aiming for the next red boy.
Okay.
The golden nugget box.
Yum yum.
And what about me?
Well,
what about the cameraman?
Do you deserve one today?
Oh, I don't know. Gimme. Thank you.
I got one.
Oh right, okay. Pardon?
Very knobbly.
Compared to the Solent, yes. It's that's Newborough Warren over there. It's not actually very high, those are only sand dunes. So we're heading for the final buoy. It's over there. It's a port hand buoy, to help in the shape, even if you can't see the colour. And then from there we hang a left and go into the entrance, which is over there.
Well, approximately.
I see it.
I think if you aim due east.
I've got it.
Yep.
You see the where the fishing pond, the new boat coming out is?
Yeah.
Right?
Yep.
You've got the headland.
Yep.
And then you've got several lumps.
Oh, I got it. Yeah, I got it. Yeah, that's it. That's the last bank. To the left-hand side of that. Muswell Bank. Well, it's clearing, isn't it, definitely?
And there's another buoy, yeah.
And although it'd be easy to put an anchor down now, it wouldn't be very nice to have to go in the water.
6 metres.
So we're going to do a sharp left-hand turn here around this buoy.
Nice bit of flood running.
C6.
And who's this on top greeting us? Louise?
I don't know.
What sort of creature are you?
Black-headed gulls, I think. Oh no, they're terns. And they're heading for the entrance.
Well, we're going to have fun going against that tide after the swellies, aren't we?
4.5 knots through the water, but 8 knots over the ground. And look at the buoy. Look at that flow.
Right, left, Mike, is it?
No, just go straight for the entrance.
Mike's doing a good job left of the leg. Left slightly. Mike?
Oh, well, you can see the channel.
Did you want job left of the leg? Left of the leg or what?
That's fine as you are.
I'm not going through the centre yet.
You've got 10 metres.
Fine as you are.
Okay. It gets really deep through here. And we'll fly through this bit.
It's fine.
9 knots.
Hi.
That's Fort Bellon. Yachts.
Hopefully, please.
Some cannons.
Five knots. 9.8 knots.
Ten knots.
Pop that like a cork.
Yeah.
10.1.
And over the water, we're only doing 4.3.
So 10.2.
10.2, yeah.
Chill on.
Huh?
Yeah, I'm saying that chill on. Yeah. It's not going to go up.
You can see an eddy up the side, can't you?
Yeah.
In fact, you can see a slope. That water is higher than we are.
it's very like Hurst, that, isn't it?
Yeah. Fort Bellon looks a bit more like a fort from this side. Beyond it is Carnarvon Castle.
I'm used to this for my racing.
Laura tide. It's a Laura tide.
Hair of a Laura tide.
Very pleasant.
Yeah, so those lights indicate that you could go into...
Yeah, is that a marina?
That is a marina
that's
now.
Victoria
The Victoria Dock, and this is a new development. And that's the change buoy, which indicates the change of the buoyage. It does say change on it.
There's walls around the trees there.
Protect them from these. Oh no, they're in a field separated by a fence. We're at the port to Norwich and we're just about to pick up a mooring and wait for a few minutes and have a cup of coffee before we go through the swellies.
I'm wondering what these birds are.
Can you identify the birds at the same time?
Yeah, they're the same ones. Red wings.
Have they got red legs?
Decision there. Got it. Masters of the universe. Yes.
Are you tied on?
I am. So, engine. Mike? I'm going to look out the window. Mike, look out the window.
Another one. Excuse me, Steve.
Yeah. Could you, Mike, get him in the lorry?
We're about to go through the swellies.
See the bridge in the distance?
Yeah.
There is the Marquess of Anglesey's column. That's Nelson.
You're a bit too right, Louise. Come left slightly and approach it from wider. It's too close to the shore.
Tell me when I can turn to it.
All right.
Okay, what?
Turn to it. Just there.
So these are the two transits we have to line up in a moment, that one and that one.
That right is shade.
But we're aiming for that pyramid over there.
Thank you.
inevitably we're being joined by a whole flotilla going through at the same time.
There is the bridge we've just been under. Okay, turn to port.
Now, turn left. A little bit more left. A little bit more left.
Yeah.
That's bang on now.
Morning.
Well, here we are in the Menai Straits, and this is very familiar territory for me because this is where I rowed when I was at university. I spent three happy years rowing here in the Menai Straits, and only once did we go through that bridge, and we gave ourselves a big scare. So it's a great thrill to have been through the Swellies with Mike and Louise on a lovely, lovely spring day in April 2011. And over here we have Menai Bridge Town, and just coming up shortly to the University Boathouse from where I rode all this time. It's a great water sports centre, the Menai Straits. There's some canoes going afloat at Menai Bridge. So there's Bangor Pier sticking away out, and Gallows Point beyond. And here, you can barely see it, that shed is the University Boathouse. there's this, and then there's these.
That's a sail, that one.
What, the one on the water's edge?
Yeah.
So it is.
This one, definitely. Because they were a Welsh band, weren't they?
Oh, right.
That's Penryn Castle over there. That's what we call top college in the university. That's the University Arts Department, Bangor.
This guy here lives, he's just picked up something with his dinghy on.
Mussel farming. That's what you need, Mike and Louise, a trimaran.
I'm saying, we have 40. Can I give you that?
Yep.
Rather than going to Ben Allison. Didn't say anything in any of the
books about it. No. No. Hey, funny
swirl here.
19 meters.
Going to inspect this pier because we've been offered a berth on it.
We might moor up the Menai Straits jetty. Just sort of come down and had a look at it, but it's, I don't really know. I'm going to moor on there without fender boards or anything like that, to be honest. I am, yeah. I'm sure, yeah. I mean, it looks fine for a ship, but, I mean... okay, fine. Well, we have a go. Okay. I'm sure there is. Yeah. All right. Okay. All right. Cheers. Thanks. Okay. He said you'd be perfectly all right there. You get hundreds of boats in there every year, and he's going to come down and give us a hand. Yeah. All right. Swing around.
Thanks, bye. Off come contacts because I'm not used to.
You're looking at the stationary water.
Well, the back eddy here.
Yeah.
In the lee of the island.
Here. Yeah. Freed from toll, 31st December 1940. Reconstructed in 1938 to 1940. Look at that for a terrace.
That's not a red one.
Which one's that, Pinky?
It's a spiny crab, isn't it?
That's not a spiny...
Dad, you hold it.
Hold the rod
while
I get it off.
Okay.
No. I wish we'd catch
a
red
eye.
He's feisty.
He's going to starve if you don't eat.
He's feisty.
Right. I'm just going to leave him on his
bed. Don't leave him. He can't leave him.
No, he can't breathe.
I can't pick him up.
No, throw him back. You can. Just watch your fingers.
That's a green crab.
You're not to catch him. In the back.
That's it.
You
manage.
Well done.
That's it. Excellent.
Well done. You're off it again.
Yes, we are.
Yeah. Before the crowds
get
there.
That's a very nice bit of wood there.
We've never owed any money, except the mortgage, of course. And my kids are the same. And Elliot's, 39 now? So it's a case of... We can do what we want to do.
Yes.
You know, we've got a lovely house now in Old Colwyn. We're overlooking the sea, which is a real bonus.
Mm-hmm.
More importantly, the wife's happy.
Hang on, wait a minute.
Sounds perfect.
I've already got one sexist man in the boat.
So
Oh, well, me?
Yeah, I'd like to think so. Successful in my the way I think and the way my attitude to things. I am a worrier. I do wake up in the middle of the night and
I think we all do.
I wake up and I think, oh, okay, I'll have to put that right.
Yeah.
And I can't sleep then until I've got it right. And then once it's right, well, that's fine, I'm happy. Mm. I'm lucky. Do you feel lucky?
Yes.
Yeah, I think so.
I feel lucky. I always feel lucky. I feel my family's lucky. Yeah. You know, we haven't had trauma.
Without getting morbid about it, you know, I'm 62 now.
You're the same age as me.
And I've got, I've still got most of my marbles left, and I'm reasonably healthy, and that's worth a tremendous amount.
Oh, yes. I look at my brother. My brother's 18 months older than I am. And he's riddled with arthritis. Yeah. He's 23 stone. He can't help himself very much. Yeah. Can't walk up my stairs.
That's tragic, isn't it?
I feel so.
It's tragic.
When I try to push, very difficult. But I think if you feel lucky, you will be lucky.
I think there's a lot to do with a positive attitude, isn't it? No, it's not it's not the be all and end all. But I think if you're positive about life, I think if you were like that in life, your kids follow the same sorts of attitudes.
I think so.
These interesting looking things. And under the water, they're all inflated. Cauliflowers. That's Gallows Point over there. And over here is Bumaris. Station. I think that's the Royal Anglesey Yacht Club. And that is Bumaris Castle.
I'm taking it.
just coming into transit now, those two masts. That is Puffin Island.
Don't worry about it.
So this is leaving the northwest exit or entrance of the Menai Strait. Yeah, I'm leaning against the engine. And we're sailing away from Puffin Island.
Away from Puffin Island.
Is the engine off? Just for the main at the moment. We've got wind.
Do you not have it?
Conway.
Thank you.
pontoons are lettered A, B, C, so we turn right in and it's A, B, C, D, E, 41.
D.
A, E, 41.
E, 41.
That's Degemwe.
Okay.
7.
41.
I've jumped ship, but Mike and Louise are still here in Conway, and showing them all the various sites, like Conway Castle here, and we're going to probably go to London there and show them out. Great tour. Because it was a real shame that when we were coming over here yesterday, you couldn't see anything, you could hardly see anything. When we'd got round Puffin Island, you could barely see Anglesey anymore. Hardly see the Snowdonia Mountains in the background. It was a real disappointment to me knowing how beautiful it all is. But the weather's slightly different today, southerly wind, so maybe it'll be a bit clearer and you can see more. But it's a lovely, lovely day. You'd think it was summer when it's only April.
Where's my dinner? Where's your dinner? Mr. Punch, I've been been very busy today. I've been cooking and I've been cleaning. And now I have to go shopping. But I've got a problem, boys and girls. I don't have anybody to look after my baby. Do you know anybody who can look after the baby for me, boys and girls? Who should look after the baby for me? Mr. Punch! Oh, that's a very good idea! You don't want to! Mr. Punch says he doesn't want to! Do you think Mr. Punch should look after the baby for me, everybody? Yes!
Running faster than us. Goats. That's Puffin Island over there. Anglesey beyond. That's what we sailed across yesterday, and we came from way down there. That's the Menai Straits. It's not very clear today. There's Bangkok. Conway Marina down there. Everybody's put their names in stones on this mountain.
see the rain, it must be underneath here.
Yeah.
Anglesey over there. Mm-hmm. Buffin Island. And our straits.
Yeah, when the breeze is coming down, same with the red tail, they automatically just open the wings when the breeze comes.
Yeah.